We're going to talk about a growing problem in these United States, and that is the problem of stress. You know, these days, when a big storm is approaching in the sky, hardly anybody gets hurt because we got warnings. We got the radar, we got the Doppler radar, we got the Joe Dinardo. Everybody's got the warnings. They get in the basement when the big storm comes because we got warnings. Now, stress has its warnings too, and that's what we're going to talk about today. That's right. There are definite warning signs a person experiences when he is under too much stress. The first one would have to be exhaustion. Just a general feeling of tiredness and the loss of the energy. A difficulty in keeping up with the daily life. This exhaustion usually leads to what we call detachment. That is a distancing of oneself from those closest to us. The moving away from those people we know. Detachment. The victims of extreme stress have neither the time nor the energy to properly pursue and build and nurture relationships. All of their time and strength is spent just trying to keep their heads above the water. You got the head down here, the water up there, they try to keep the head above the water. Of course, detachment always leads to the next step. The sensation that nothing is new, nothing is fresh, and the feeling that they will never ever be nice again. Once this boredom sets in, it is only a short hop. First we had the step in the water, now we got the hop. The short hop to the next step, and that is cynicism. The one follows the other. And they both have to feed off of each other like this until finally the victim becomes impatient with those around him, and that soon leads to extreme irritability as the stress takes hold. Well, the impatience grows, you know, and the flare-ups, they start to occur. Then they start to blame the people that's closest to them for all the things that are actually their fault. This usually results in the breaking up of the relationship. Of course, these are just the preliminary symptoms. Once these here preliminaries take hold, they move quickly to the more serious symptoms, and those are being a feeling of omnipotence. That's from the Greek omnipotence. Many of these stress victims say to themselves, nobody can do a job like me. I'm the only one who can do this job. And sometimes they only think, not even God could do this job. Just me. Now, while these feelings are completely involuntary, they got no control here. It goes without saying that the subliminal mindset borders on a delusional. And that's not from the Greek. From here, we move on to the next sign of extreme stress. And it is a very significant sign. It is the belief that the victim is unappreciated. The stressed out person went through a maze of feelings here. They include bitterness, anger, offense, and high anxiety because he feels like his work is not appreciated. This belief usually results in a deviation from his normal work patterns. You know, he goes to work and now all of a sudden he's late and stuff. He becomes more tyrannical, demanding, and inflexible. And here, from here, it's a very small step. So before we had the big step and the hop and the water, now we got the big step here to the next symptom. Paranoia. Just because you think they're out to get you don't mean they aren't. This, of course, is a very serious condition. This can have many long-term and damaging effects. The stressed victim will become disoriented and his thought processes will wander. The victim will have increased difficulty in communicating. He will lose his ability to concentrate. Yes, and his memory for names, dates, and even what he was starting to say will dwindle away. Pardon? He will joke about his increasing old age, and thus he tried to cover up the problems further. This is an unattractive explanation for his very poor performance in life, so another reason must be found. Physical ailments. These bodily complaints can appear and flourish anywhere on the victim. All of a sudden like that. In the head, the back, the sinuses, and even the entire muscular structure. Although these problems may be rare, remember they are usually brought on by the extreme emotional stress that the person is suffering from. And of course, all of these things can lead to one of the most devastating stages of all. Depression. Not the kind that's with the dent in the hood, but the depression up here in the brain. This is the voice stage because this can springboard. You know, we had the step and the up and the little step, now I got the springboard into even more serious behavior later on. So, to sum up, these are just a few of the warning signs that a person is suffering from extreme stress. The truly alarming thing is that most people refuse to recognize the symptoms even when they're confronted with them face to face. Here they are, here they is, right there. They tend to want to shut out any potential help. This has been Dr. Sigmund Floyd with your Mental Health Minute.